This is the innovation area at the Barber Museum. So we're just gonna start here with some unique kind of artwork they have. So 125 generic, like a life engine or something. It's a project called the Bandit Series. Morning. This is a Kawasaki mystery ship based on a KZ-1000. Britain, V-1000, made in New Zealand, very, very advanced for its time, but at the same time, very rare. Look at the workmanship in that engine. This is a motorcycle designed and built in 1996. Forward thinking look. It's still used on a lot of race bikes today. It's a Motus V4. This is the MSTR. Unfortunately, I don't believe Motus is operating anymore. They were a company out of Birmingham. This is a 1650cc V4. Again, just a beautiful motorcycle. It's hard to compete with the big guys. Cross-section of some of the more modern sport bikes and race bikes. This is a 2014 EBR, the Eric Buell. So, again, you can kind of see the evolution. That's an old Buell Lightning. More Buells. It's pretty much the Buell section right here. You can see we started at the later bikes, and now we're kind of working our way back to some of the earlier ones. In the early days, Buell was known for taking a Harley and turning it into a sports bike, which is no small feat. partnered with Harley. They ran their 1000cc V-twin in the Battle of the Twins. Again, a lot of the unique designs that people have come up with were put into this aerodynamics and the suspension setup. And this is Buell's first go at a road racer. This is his RW750 built in 1984, back when he used two-stroke power. So it's a square four, essentially. I'll try and get in here where you can kind of see the engine layout a little bit. But, so, two sets, you can either call it two inline fours or two horizontal, or two inline twins or two horizontal twins, however you want to lay it out. But they're, you know, just basically, in order to have rotary valves in each cylinder for a carburation, you need the four independent cylinders running on two cranks. So, unique design, purpose-built racer, and small privateer doing his thing. So that concludes this part of the tour. Again, if you've liked it, you can turn in and subscribe to the Old Motor Dude channel. Thank you.